sorry for the net. A bit trouble with LCD projector, so I have to set up like this so everyone can see. It's okay, it's okay so far. I don't know why, because when I test yesterday in my campus, it's fit well. Okay, let's start today's session. My name Dixie from Keiyogijuku Daigaku Sonan Fujisawa Campus. I'm working on wet project and also Soyasia project. So this is my today my agenda about introduction, network operation, and human resources. So I would like talk here is a little bit different from other talk. Let's see the other point of view using a BSD operating system from the end of user. So what is Soyasia project? It's part of the WIDE project. It's a distance learning platform and also try to contributing to higher education development in Asia countries through the utilization of internet and digital technology. Okay, this is better. So far we have so far we have 27 universities and research institutes partner in 13 countries. So what we do here is we deploy the receive-only satellite receiver earth station in every country, our partners. And for the detail, you can read about our project in that URL. This is a Soyasia global map here. So we have a lot of partners here in 13 countries using connectivity using satellite unidirectional, mean one-way satellite link. We have a cooperation with GCSat, that is a Japan corporation for satellite. We have 13 megabits capacity satellite link from Japan to Asia. So if we look more detail, Soyasia network is like this. So we have here we have the relay set at Keio University, and here we have lecture site. So the lecture site not only in Japan but can be anywhere. So we have experience lecture site in USA. So, and this is student site partners in mostly in Asia. And this is a typical network of Soyasia project. So we have satellite link, we have UDL satellite receiver, and we have receive router. And this is mostly in our partner site in several countries. And our partner site must have outgoing internet connection to the internet. So what I'm talk will be a little bit detail about FreeBSD on here in receiver router and satellite receiver. So if you have a comment or question, just raise your hand. So this is a one-way satellite wing. We have satellite receiver. Currently we use a proprietary device, but soon we will change to Linux DVB. We try to looking for the BSD DVB, but so far we couldn't find a solution. But our receive router is using FreeBSD, and its partner must provide the internet connections. So regarding about unidirectional learning, because Soy Asia is this distance learning platform real time, so we have class in the university. Of in the class, we need interaction between a lecture professor sensei with and the students. But we only have one way link, unidirectional. So we have find solution how to emulate a bidirectional communication to unidirectional. And the solution is appear in RFC number 3077. It's about UDLR. Before next steps, so I would like to explain that why we use unidirectional satellite link. Because unidirectional satellite link is very cheap. And then it doesn't need government license. That's why we deploy many satellite earth station in many countries for this project. So this is a unidirectional figure. How the packet, if we want like to send a packet from site, this is our partner sites in several countries. So if we want to send, for example, a video or audio to lecture site to professor in Japan, so the source must be sent to receiver router. And receiver router forward to UDL, I mean to satellite receiver, but because this is unidirectional link, the UDL cannot forward to satellite. So the satellite receive encapsulate the IP packet with GRE and then forward back to receiver router. Receiver router then forward back to the our partner's university gateway SP router. Then forward to internet on the lecture side, on professor side, the packet will be decapsulated and the professor can see the student. Okay, this is still same. Here's in is more detail, but in OC layer, if we have IP packet in, this is in our partners, we forward to receiver, but because this is UDL, I mean one way, we cannot forward to satellite, then it encapsulated and forward to ISP and partner site to internet, and then here's the on lecture sites, the packet will be decapsulated. And then the professor happy can see the student. So this is about a network operation layer 3. So all of our receive router using FreeBSD, mostly still old, I guess some has 4.11, some has 5.4. And we use OSPF version 3 for unicast routing protocol. We have /40H IPv6 global address to partners, so we assign. We have /32, but we assign partners. We give the partners /40H IPv6 global addresses to partners. And currently, we are using Zebra routing daemon for this unicast routing on receive router. So for the multicast routing, it's still same. This picture. So in this receive router, in every partners, we running the unicast routing platform using Zebra. And also we running multicast routing daemon on the same machine. The reason to use multicast we have because we have limited bandwidth, so we have to send the packet on the same time, and because this is the real-time class. Okay, so the multicast still running on the receive router. What we have to do on FreeBSD to enable multicast routing, just add option mrouting to the kernel and recompile the kernel. Then the FreeBSD machine have a multicast forwarding enable. And PMSM for multicast routing protocol, it's currently we use a ZORP routing protocol, routing daemon. Next, this is example traffic on UDL network. So the red one is IPv6 traffic and the blue one is IPv4 traffic. This is example how when the class appear, for example from Japan to our partner in several countries in Asia. This is typical traffic that we have. And this time in this scale time is in GST, Japan Standard Time. Okay, now the interesting things is this traffic we divide between multicast traffic and unicast. So the red one is the multicast traffic, means video and audio from lecture site, from professor to our partners in several countries in Asia. And the blue one is unicast traffic, maybe some our partners use the UDL for downloading materials from web or something like that. Also, this is the typical traffic when we have class in SoAsia. Next is, this is example our global multicast operation. We have experience about 2 years ago on ACMCCOM 2007 in Kyoto. So we we broadcast all of the session on CCOM 2007 in Kyoto to our partners and also to other sites. This is on this global multicast operation. So from the so in this case, the CCOM become a lecture set. So from speaker give presentation, tutorial like that, and then from the lecture site at Kyoto, it's sent to Keio University, and then from Keio University we broadcast the lecture to tutorial to our partners via satellite link on SoAsia. But also we had lectures that relay broadcast to our partners using other line. For example, in these pictures, the audio and video stream goes to Thailand and Indonesia also. So what I want to say in this graph that we have global multicast operation with easy solution using FreeBSD as multicast router platform. Okay, next. So in SoAsia project, besides technical aspect such as network operation, unicast, multicast routing, we have to solve the help partners if they have problem with Unicast OSPF routing protocol or multicast routing protocol. So we also provide the annual workshop. The reason is we have to refresh the network operator in every our partners. And other reason is because mostly network operator in our partners in several countries is student. So student can be stay forever in the campus because sometimes he must be graduate. Okay, for example, bachelor degree only 4 years in the campus. So after 4 years, probably he will graduate and works outside. So we provide the annual workshop every year. So for every new operator in our partners. So mostly the material on the annual workshops is quite basic. For example, basic FreeBSD, for example, how to compile the kernel configurations, and also how to assign several variables, for example, network interface and also IP addressing in /atg/rc.conf, and also how to install and configuring Zebra, how to installing and configuring Zorb in this case, and little bit checking and debugging. It's very this workshop is very important and very valuable for our network operator in our partners, because lot of problem we face on this project, and sometimes partner have some network operator sometimes have to ask via email to ask how to resolve some problem. So that's why we create annual workshop to refresh the knowledge and how to resolve some problem if happen in the networks. So we have workshop model. First is face to face. It happened a few years ago. Face to face is good workshop model because we come and gather together in classroom. We practically, so the lecturer can observe the progress of every network operators. And then also the participant or network operators can experiment directly with hardware or devices. That's the advantages of the face-to-face workshop. But the disadvantages of face-to-face workshop is it's very expensive. Contoh tak kayak disini. So we have to fly, for example, on 2006 we have to fly to Indonesia getting workshop there. We also have to order some PC for rentaling PC for the workshop. So it's very very costly to do this face to face workshop. And also the disadvantage is to order the in several countries to order the devices or computer for workshop is quite difficult because we need the same specification. It's quite difficult in some countries. That's why that's the disadvantages of face to face workshop model. And next we have a virtual machine. So we deploy the virtual machine in KU University using VMware, and then send some virtual PC on that virtual machine. So every network operators access to that virtual machine via internet. This is good. I mean, it's not so costly as face-to-face model. But some countries has difficulties how to connectivity to virtual machine because, for example, some our partners have very bad internet connectivity, for example, in Myanmar. So sometimes the SSH disconnected in the middle of the workshop. And next, the last is the cluster machine using Starbed from JAIS, Japan Advanced Institute of Technology in Ishikawa. So we book about almost 200 machine in Starbed Ishikawa. And Starbed is a project from Japan government for network protocol testbed. So if you want to test your protocol in large scale, for example, you may use Starbed, this facility Starbed. It's mostly almost little bit same with Planet Lab, but it's Starbed more cluster. I mean, you can come or you can access directly to the machines. So for example, here's this is the photo of the Starbed from JAIS in Ishikawa King. Okay, this is the Starbed topology briefly. Basically, we have the experimental nodes here, and then we have the management network, and this is for users, internet, and then this is special node, means for, so Starbed has a facility to put special, if we have want to experiment with special hardware, we can put our hardware in Starbed on that parts. So what we have to do last year in FreeBSD workshop, I mean the annual workshop of Soyuzia. This is the example workshop topology that we have in Starbed. So we book several about almost 200 computer nodes in Starbed. So every network protos log to the machine and try to exercise our materials, workshop materials. This is the topology that we create in Starbed. So this topology basically can be created automatically because the Starbed has been provided script automatically that can be changed the topology very fast. So we don't need to think or we don't need to spend a lot of effort if we need to change the topology, because in our workshop we have three topology, and then to change from other topology to other topology in our workshop is quite fast with help from facility from Starbed. So this is a work to do with our project is, for example, is Doko Demo Soi. I mean, we try to build a kind of USB image so everyone can install Linux or FreeBSD using USB and then receive the lecture anywhere, Doko Demo. It's and then next work to do in our project is building FreeBSD customized FreeBSD ISO image. As we know that FreeBSD ISO image default kernel configuration doesn't include M routing option, so we have to add several option to the kernel, for example M routing. And also probably we have to building the ISO image that including the routing daemon to FreeBSD ISO image, Zebra or SOAP. The reason why we have to building customized ISO image is because we need to deploy the new site in very fast. I mean, in our experience, deploying new site, for example, we have to go to the other countries, install the receive router. Usually, if we deploy the new site, the earth station antenna is already provided by the partner, so we only configure the satellite receiver and also the routing, I mean the receive router. On the receive router, we need to configure a lot of many things, so it's wasting time. And also, it's very costly because from Japan we have to go to other countries. But with building ISO image, customized, we can only send the ISO image to the partners, new partners, and then ask partners to install this FreeBSD ISO image like this, like this, like this. So this is can be cheap because we don't need to go to other countries, and then it can be very fast because it's only installed and it's run. It doesn't need to configure something else because we already configure the FreeBSD ISO image before. And then the next to do in our project is considering one routing daemon using SOAR, probably using SOAR, because currently we running routing daemon in FreeBSD router using Zebra and SOAR. It has two routing daemon, so we would like to eliminate probably Zebra because SOAR is routing suite that's already including OSPF, BGP, and then RIP, and then multicast. So it's completed routing suite. So we considering only use SOAR for routing platform. Can be run OSPF and multicast only in this project. So it can be save lot of time for configuring receive router in this project, mostly in the new site. And okay, so in this presentation I have described FreeBSD as multicast and unicast and multicast router platform in this project. It has been run very well in certain countries in our 27 partners, almost about 8 years ago. So it's run until now. And also some partners still has old FreeBSD version. It's no problem, as well as it ran very well. Okay, thank you for coming. If you have any comment or question, yes.
Do you have any problem with latency?
Latency?
Yeah, I am curious about how it affects.
Yes. Because this is satellite link, because latency is problem. I mean, it's not problem, it's given from there. It's very natural we have latency in satellite link. It's about, because it's one way, it's only about, from my experience, it's about only 200 milliseconds. And then, after several, when the project is running about several years ago, 8 years ago, we have the senior senpai has been testing, and then with this unidirectional link, we have to stream video and audio to several countries and then back to us, then calculate, then this latency is quite good. I mean, it's very acceptable. Video audio is very acceptable. Yeah, usually in the Japan side, we only have latency to the audio, and visually you can see latency from the audio. Most it's less, but it's about one second, and it's very acceptable. Very acceptable as long as the audio is not broken. I mean, we can hear the sound very clearly, and it's acceptable for this class. That's my answers. If you have any question or comments, if not, thank you very much for coming. Arigatou gozaimashita. Tsukare sama desu.